I am also a mental health first aider and I learned this at my course. So I want to ask you, which area in the world has the highest suicide rate? Area. Okay, someone says Japan. Europe? Asia? Uh-huh. Anybody guess? Come on, guess.
India.
India, okay, uh-huh. The answer is the village Kalenga in Tanzania has the highest suicide rate in the world. Tanzania is actually number 8. These are only reported cases of suicide. There are so many unreported cases as well. Suicide. One of the highest causes of suicide, mental health disorders, and child abuse. Now, do you all have phones here? You all have phones, right? So there's a statistic. I'd like you all to remove your phones. Take out your phones. Sawa? For those who have phones, you can take them out. And the statistics show that there are over 800,000 people who die in Tanzania every day by committing suicide. So now, 800,000 divided by 365. I'm not so good at mathematics, so you can help me out. So how many people die with suicide every single day? Uh-huh.
22.
800,000 divided by 365.
2,200.
Yeah, close. 2,191 people die every day in Tanzania by committing suicide. And these statistics were revealed by the World Health Organization, WHO. Therefore, children, coming back to the subject of child abuse, children should not be scared telling their parents that, "Mom, Dad, I have failed an exam." That should not happen. Children should not be worried telling their parents that they have been bullied on social media. Children should not be scared informing their parents that they want to take a different career than that intended by the parents. And children should not be scared, should not be apprehended and fearful telling their parents that I have been physically, sexually or emotionally abused. So, we need to take a stance, and we need to take a stance quickly. We heard Dr. Sabrina, once again I'd like to request you all to give her a round of applause once again for a wonderful presentation. But now, how are we going to avoid mental, how are we going to avoid physical child abuse? All the abuses that we heard, how? Number one, we need to have more organizations enhancing mental health knowledge and combating child abuse. We need to have many organizations. There is a lady by the name of Dr. Sunita Krishna. How many of you have heard of her? Sunita Krishna. She's the founder of an organization called Prajwala. What is it called? Prajwala. And she's an activist, and this NGO, it aims at rescuing, rehabilitating and reintegrating children who have been trafficked. You've heard of child trafficking? Children who have been trafficked and have been abused sexually, she plans to rescue them, rehabilitate them and reintegrate them within the society. And she has served around 12,000 of these children who have been sexually abused during trafficking. Let's have such an organization in Tanzania as well. Let us have this organization, not only 1, 2, 3, 10, 100 thousands organizations that aim at bringing change and impacting society and educating our society. So I'd like to end by this. I know you're hurting. I know you're in trauma. For those who have been sexually abused, for children who have been abused, I know you're in pain. I know you're dejected. I know you're emotionally drained and exhausted. I know you're unhappy, but there is hope. There is someone watching over you. There is an entity watching over you. Many examples: Oprah Winfrey, Bill Clinton, Marilyn Monroe, George Orwell. Initially, they were abused during their childhood, but they had hope. I'll quote the Bhagavad Gita and end. The Bhagavad Gita, chapter 17, verse number 3. Whatever the nature of their faith, that is verily what they are. Have faith, have hope, and we will be able to overcome all the trials and tribulations within the society. The clothing is not responsible for the abuse, as Dr. Sabrina said. The clothing is not responsible for the abuse. The victim is not responsible for the abuse. The abuser, the perpetrator, is responsible for the abuse. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Ejaz.